Good morning students, welcome back to social studies class. I hope you all are doing fine. Take your social science book, page number 21. Today we will see the new chapter. The name of the chapter is the Northern Plains. Let us start. The Indo-Gangetic Plains are also known as the Northern Plains or the North Indian River Plains. They are a large and fertile plain surrounding most of the northern and eastern India. The northern plains of India are one of the most fertile plains of the world. These plains lie between the Himalayas and the southern plateaus. It feeds its numerous rivers and are source of the fertile alluvium deposited across the region by the two river system. Let us explain in detail. The northern mountains are the crown of India, you know very well. The northern plains are the face of the country. Where it is the northern plains? Let us see the location of the northern plain. Look at this Indian map. Where it is the northern plain? The northern plain lies between the Himalayas and southern plateaus. The flat and level northern plains stretch from Punjab in the western side Punjab to Assam in the east. The northern plains stretch from Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. They cover the whole of Punjab, Haryana, West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, parts of Bihar and Assam. So the northern plain almost cover the whole of Punjab, Haryana, West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, parts of Bihar and Assam. The northern plains are very fertile plains. Here rich in alluvial soil in most parts. The most cities in the northern plains are Amritsar, Delhi, Agra, Kanpur, Lucknow, Allahabad, Varanasi, Patna, Kolkata, Guwahati and Chandigarh. So the Indo-Gangetic Plains are also known as the Northern Plains or North Indian River Plains. Underline the Indo-Gangetic Plains are also known as the Northern Plains. Underline it. So these Northern Plains are one of the most fertile plains of the world. The location of the Northern Plain lies between the Himalayas in the southern plateaus. So the northern plains stretch from the Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. They cover almost the whole of Punjab, Haryana, West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, parts of Bihar and Assam. So here the northern plains are mostly very fertile plains, rich in alluvial soil in most parts. Is it clear? Division of plains of northern India. The three great rivers, Satluj, Ganga, Brahmaputra, divide the northern plains into three parts: the Satluj basin, the Ganga basin and the Brahmaputra basin. So the northern plains have three important rivers: the Satluj, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. They divide the plains into three river basins. A river basin is an area watered by a river and its tributaries. The three river basins in India are Satluj River Basin, Ganga River Basin, Brahmaputra River Basin. Let us see the Satluj River Basin. Look at the Indian map. Where it is the Satluj Basin? The Satluj and the Bias flow in the southwest direction. They join the Indus River in Pakistan. The Indus flows into the Arabian Sea. So less than one third of the Indus Basin is situated in India, in the parts of Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh and Punjab. It is about 2900 km and its primary tributaries include the Satluj, Bias, Ravi, Chenab and the Zelum. These rivers have turned the plains of country's northern region extremely fertile. The main crops grown in this region are wheat, sugarcane, rice and cotton. The Bagranagal Dam has been constructed on the Satluj River. Amritsar, Jalandhar, Ludhiana, Ambala, Chandigarh are some important cities of the basin. So the Satluj and the Bias flow in the southwest direction. They join the Indus River in Pakistan, The Indus flow into the Arabian Sea. Punjab and Haryana lie in the Satluj Basin. The Bakranangal Dam has been built on the Satluj River. It provides water for irrigation. Electricity is also produced at the Bakranangal Dam. Punjab and Haryana are two important states which get water and electricity from the Bakranangal Dam. Is it clear? The Ganga Basin. Look at this Indian map, where it is there, the location of Ganga Basin. It is pointed out as in green color. So the Ganga is considered as the most scarred river of our country. It originates as Bhagirathi from a glacier called Gangodari. The Alaknanda and Madagani rivers join Bhagirathi on its way down the hills. The combined water of all these rivers flow as the Ganga. The river Yamuna originates from a glacier called Yamunodari, joins Ganga at Allahabad. This place is called Sangam. So what is Sangam? The river Yamuna originates from a glacier called Yamunodari, joins Ganga at Allahabad. This place is called Sangam. Underline the Himalayan rivers which join the Ganga after Allahabad from west to east are the Gomti, the Kantak and the Kosi. The flow of rivers slows down due to the load of sediments it carries. Therefore, before entering sea, it leaves the deposits of its sediments on its mouth and hence branches into distributaries form a delta. So here, what is a delta? Before entering sea, it leaves the deposits of its sediments on its mouth and hence branches into distributaries and form a delta. The Ganga and the Brahmaputra join together in Bangladesh and make a largest delta in the world called the Sundarban. Which is the largest delta in the world? Sundarban Delta. The Ganga and Brahmaputra join together in Bangladesh and make the largest delta in the world called the Sundarban Delta. Brahmaputra Basin.
Brahmaputra
Look at the
Basin.
Map.
Look at the image of Indian map.
Red color. It is pointed out. This Basin area is in red called color. Brahmaputra Basin.
So the Brahmaputra river originates in Tibet, where it is called the Yarlang Jangpo. This river is longer compared to the Indus, and most of its course lies in Tibet. In Arunachal Pradesh, it is called Dihang. After the convergence of the Logit River and Dibang River, it is named the Brahmaputra. Finally, it enters Bangladesh and falls into the Bay of Bengal. This region of India is very fertile due to the heavy rainfall. It is called the Bowl of India. The Brahmaputra is the longest of the three rivers of North India. So three rivers of North India,
it starts
the Satluj River and Ganga River, Brahmaputra is the longest
India
of the three rivers of North India. It starts in Tibet where it is called Bangladesh. It enters India through Arunachal Pradesh and flows through Assam before entering Bangladesh.
That's all for
the Brahmaputra Basin called the Food Bowl of India. That's all for today class. I hope you all understood. Meet you in the next class. Till then, revise the topic taught. Thank you. Have a nice day.